Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to be working on our 2011 Polaris Sportsman 850. And as you can tell, we've already been working on it a little bit. What we're going to do today, now that we've got the engine out and somewhat cleaned up, we're going to start pulling it down and see what's going on inside of this. What was it doing? Well, it was still running, but it had low compression, especially on one of the cylinders. Beyond that, it seemed to be pushing up a lot of oil through the breather system, you know, into the air box. Something's going on in there. Not sure what. Probably going to bend the end up being the piston and rings, but we're going to start breaking it apart and see what's what. Let's get started. All right, guys, let's go over some of the tools that you're going to need for the head inspection project. One of the most important ones is a 14 millimeter. It needs to be pretty healthy, and it also needs to be a 12 point. That's going to be used to pull your head bolts. Other than that, just your standard 3/8 sockets, a few different drives. At least need an 8, a 10, and a 12 millimeter. And if you don't already have a full set of Allens, you're going to need that as well. You know, starting off at 2 and going up to 10. I think we only used a couple of them on this project. As always, you can need a little hammer, screwdriver, pick tool, magnet, and then a couple of Marksaw pins so you can keep up with where the valves are inside the head. Beyond that, the only specialty tool you're going to need is a valve spring compressor. It really doesn't matter which manufacturer you want to go with. Just want to make sure that this area here is not bigger or round than the actual top of the valve spring holder. All right, so let's get started on this. First thing that needs to come off is just the valve cover held on by, I think, 6 8 millimeter bolts. So let's go ahead and get those out. As I've said before, you know, I like these little impact drivers, but they're great for taking things apart. I do not recommend them to use them when you're putting them back together, because you're probably going to strip it out. So just be careful with these things when you use them. Interesting little note here. See that? Kind of milky white substance up in there. It tells me that this oil may have been contaminated with water at some point in time. Is this what that indicates? This is also a little bit scary. See that bolt right there? That is hand tight. It's kind of like doing an expedition. You're never going to know what you're going to find in one of these machines when you start pulling it apart. All right, guys, what we want to do here is go ahead and bring around the camshaft to top dead center. And what we're going to be looking for is a little protrusion that's going to come up vertical, and then we're going to turn it another 60 degrees, and that'll relieve the tension on the rocker box. All right. So it's come past the vertical, and then there's a mark right here that should be even with the head itself. All right, from this point, we don't have any tension on the rocker box. What we do need to do next is go ahead and pull the tensioner on the cam chain itself. Once we get that, that'll loosen up the tension on the sprocket and the chain. We can go ahead and remove the rocker box and then get our chain off the sprocket. All right, you want to notice on the tensioner, it's actually directional, and it has a little stamp that says top. I don't think it's possible to actually install it incorrectly, but they're just making sure. Just a couple of 8 millimeter bolts. There we go. All right, let's go ahead and get those rocker box bolts out now. Everything's looking pretty good in here. I still don't like the fact that there is so much of that milky colored oil in here. Maybe whatever caused that will come to light as we go along. But I don't see any abnormal wear so far, which is a good thing. All right, let's go ahead and get that camshaft bolt out so we can get this chain off. Thank you. All right, at this point, if you were not going to pull the head off, which I am, I would suggest putting a wire on this chain to hold it up. But since I know I'm going further down into the engine, I'm just going to go ahead and let it drop. All right, next, we need to pull the six main head bolts up top. Then you got 2 8-millimeters over here. Don't forget about those. And then she should just lift off. All right, before I start pulling this part, like I said, you want to get these 2 8-millimeters out of the way. And there's a pattern that you need to follow up here. You're going to do these at about an 1/8 inch of a turn on each one. And the pattern is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And you just want to keep repeating that until all the bolts are completely loose. This is a 14 millimeter socket that you're going to need. Need to make sure it has a 12 point, because a regular 6 point ain't going to work. So a 12 point on there. It takes a fair amount of torque to get these things going, so you may have to have somebody help you hold the engine with a breaker bar to get these things started. All right, guys, we got everything loosened up and backed out. Boy, wasn't that fun. I know that tightening these things down, you take them to like 43.5 pounds, and then you put another 90 degrees on it. Where does that end up? My best guess, probably at least 100 foot-pounds. And it sure felt it when we were pulling this thing apart. It took 3 of us to hold it down. So good luck with that. All right, go ahead and get these 8 millimeters out of the way. Remove all of these. Oh, I'm about to forget something. Don't forget to disconnect this little hose on the back side that goes up to the thermostat. Just like that. All right, off she comes. All right, guys, here's what I'm seeing so far. Nothing really out of whack on the heads. I mean, a fairly good burn pattern. A little bit of carbon buildup, nothing that extreme. I do want to go ahead and pull the valves out, take a look at the seats, see if they're seated properly. What we want to do is go ahead and number all the valves. That way, if we decide to reuse them, which I'm 99% sure we will be, they go back in the same place. That way we don't have to recut seats or anything like that. So you want to get a Marksol or a Sharpie that is not black. I'm using a silver one here. So go ahead and get those marked. Set it up in there where your valve is sitting directly down on this point. This little cup to help hold it in place. Reach in there with a little magnet. Pow! Out comes that keeper. What I'm doing now, just pulling the valve in just a little bit and see how much play there is in there. Honestly, that feels perfect, nice and smooth, hardly any play at all. That steel, that seal at the very top, you still feel how it's pliable. Looking at the valve, I don't see any score marks. Extremely smooth. I don't feel any lips, any edges right here or right here. The valve's moving in and out on the valve guide itself. And if it were really worn, you'd feel a lip or an edge, one of those two spots. And it's nice and smooth all the way across. Next thing we're looking at is the actual seat of the valve, or the valve face. You can see where it's riding in the seat of the head. I don't see anywhere where it's blowing past it. So I'm betting these are sealed up pretty well. I don't feel any edge on there. Same story on the valve seat. You can see that edge all the way around, or that circle all the way around. It's even. There's no carbon or buildup or anything that I can see to where it was not sealed up properly. So this head is in good shape. I mean, just judging by this one valve, not being lazy here, but if this looks this good, chances are the rest of them are gonna look just like that. Man, that was an exhaust or an intake valve that I just pulled. We'll pull just one of the exhaust, just for fun, jump over to the other cylinder, take a look at it. If it looks that good, I'm just gonna put back together and I think it should be good to go. Exhaust is telling the same story as we saw on the intake side. A little bit of carbon buildup, nothing that dramatic. Seat looks even all the way around. No funny wear or marks anywhere. So yeah, this head looks to be in good shape. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and put those valves back in and then get back over to the engine, start pulling it apart. All right, guys, with the valves back in, this one's pretty much ready to go. I'm just going to go back and clean it up a little bit more, and it'll be ready to go back on the engine, get some of this, you know, residual sludge. There had a whole lot of it in there, but just want to get it back clean before we put it back on the engine. Now, listen, this part of the diagnosis of the engine is complete, so this piece is ready to go back. What we are going to do is go further into the engine. So that means we're going to split it in half, take a look at those piston and rings and the cylinder bore, see how that looks. So you need to come back and follow up on our next video, find out what's really going on with this machine. Listen, we appreciate you watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks.